Hello, in this video, I'm going to prepare the 2D drawings of this project by showing it in real time in section and plan views in the page layout and using a display mode provided by VisualARQ, which is the hidden display mode, that would let us print what we see directly to vector output. So I'm going to create a new page layout, clicking on this button next to the viewport tabs. I will select new layout, define the page name, printer, size, and the initial detail count. I will just select one by now and click OK. So this generates a new page. I am working now on the paper space, but if I double click inside this detail viewport, I will be able to work inside the model. I can rotate this, I can work with the geometry if I want. And if I switch to hidden display mode inside this detail viewport, I will be able to print what I see directly to vector output. If I want to exit the edition of this detail, I just need to do double click on any area, and I will be now working back on the paper space. Now, let's set here the ground floor of the project. I will need to open the level manager, click inside the detail. I'm going to select the ground floor and click on this button to set the plan view to that existing detail. This will make a zoom extent according to the geometry I have in this model. We'll switch to that ground floor, activating the cut plane, and switching also to the hidden display mode if I was using another one. Now, I just need to adjust the scale by selecting the detail, and from the properties panel, I'm gonna set here one specific scale, for example, 200. I'm going to use the detail control points to resize the detail dimensions. I'm going to disable the snaps for 1 second. And I'm going to move this detail up to the top left corner. I'm going to do 2 more copies of this detail. I can enable the OSNAPS pack. And now I will set the first floor on that detail viewport and the terrace floor in that other one. So I will double click inside this detail. I'm going to go back to the level manager and just double click on the first floor. This will just enable the first floor on that level and will keep the same scale as I had before. And I will do the same for that other one. I will double click on the terrace floor. And after exiting the detail edition, I will see the terrace floor on that level. So as long as I am using the hidden display mode inside these details, I will be able to print this directly to vector output. I can add a couple more details here for showing 2 sections. In that case, I'm going to move to the drafting tab. I will run the detail command. So I'm going to just draw a rectangle to define the new detail viewport. And I will click inside here. I'm going to go to the section manager, select the section that I want to display in this detail. And in that case, I'm going to select this button to set that section view to that detail viewport. The display mode inside this detail will also switch to the hidden one. The section has been enabled in that viewport and has been aligned to that viewport as well, and the zoom has taken the length of the section line as a reference. So again, I may need to select the detail, go to the properties of this detail, and adjust here the scale to a more common value, for example, 15. I can make a copy of this detail. And now I click inside here, I'm gonna display here the other section. So I go to the section manager, select the section 2, and click on this button to adjust it to this, to align it to this viewport. Again, I will need to readjust the scale, so I go to the properties of the detail, and in this case, it has preserved the same scale. I can finally add some text here. So I'm gonna go back to the drafting tools, go to text, and here, for example, I will write the title for the ground floor, and maybe also the scale. The height should be some value like 5. I'm gonna move it here. I'm just gonna copy this text at the bottom left corner of each detail just to add some titles to the other drawings. So this would be the first floor. This would be the terrace. And this would be the section 1. And this one, the section 2. So these drawings are real-time views of the 3D model. That means that if I change anything on the 3D model, this will show the changes automatically. I could finish this layout by adding here some title block. I could do this just by drawing it with Rhino 2D objects, for example, a rectangle for the title block here. I could add smaller boxes. Add some text, and I could finally make a block out of it that I can reuse in other layouts. Finally, if I want to show the section lines in any of these drawings, I can enable the layer where they are located. But in this case, I will hide this layer per detail viewport because I don't want to see the section lines in these two details, but I want to see them in that other one. In order to do so, I will click inside the detail where I want to hide these objects, and just notice that next to the visibility columns, I will have an extra column to add the visibility in the current page layout detail. So if I hide this layer on the detail, the sections will be hidden all in this detail viewport. When I click inside that other detail, I'll have this on, so I'm gonna turn it off just to show the sections in this detail. Finally, I'm just gonna select section 3 and hide it also. I can also move the section line a little bit, so it sections a little bit this there. And as you can see, this section shows the changes immediately. And just one last thing. If I want to show any of these section lines above the rest of the model, I can just change its drawing order by selecting the section. I will need to double click to select the section line, and from the drafting tools, run the bring to front command.